God told me to tell you there's some stuff you don't have because you're still trying to prove to people you are who he said you are. There are those of you who are putting on and you're putting on for people, and you're not going to get what God will have you to get as long as you're putting on. When you are thriving, you don't speak the same level as people who are surviving. It's just a different level. Like, you know, it's just different talk, amen? And so what's crazy is there's some individuals that was dogging Dion out for telling my man, who was the commentator, he kept stopping him like, yo, bro, talk like you normally talk to me.
Football coach, Coach Prime, Coach, how you feeling today?
No, straight up.
I always ask you how you feeling.
You was not talking like that just 2 minutes ago. Can you do the interview? Can you come in like you normally sound?
I just want to be clear and concise.
And professional?
Yes, sir.
So being you is not professional?
Well, I mean, I can't say, hey, what's up, Cole? I can't do that.
I ain't asked you to do that. I just want you to be you.
Okay, yes, sir. All right, let me start over.
Right.
All right. Joining me is Jackson State coach, Coach Prime. Is that the same?
Dog, it's the same. Like, just be you. Just try your best to be you.
Okay. All right. I thought I was doing that. But anyway, I want to just ask you, you feeling okay?
See, like, if I say, man, what's up, Rob J? That's me. What's up, Rob J? You know the difference? Did you see the difference? That's what you do. And I don't know who you're trying to please out there, but I just want you to try your best to be you.
He was like, what you doing? He's like, when they turn the camera on, you start talking different. Like, talk to me like you was talking to me a minute ago. Like, be your authentic self is what he was trying to say. He was just saying, be you. And my man was like, well, you know, I'm being professional. He said, well, you not professional. Like, you are professional. What type of professional are you trying to be? Listen to me. You cannot go viral. I want to use today's language. You can't go viral not being your authentic self. You got to be your authentic self to go viral. Does that make sense? So I'm going to start all over before I get into my message today. There are those of you who are putting on and you're putting on for people, and you're not going to get what God will have you to get as long as you're putting on. Just be your authentic self. Now, here's what happens. I'm going to be real. Here's what happens when you're your authentic self. You're going to lose a lot of people. You're going to lose a lot of people, but you're going to gain people who will ride or die. Does that make sense? I was telling Jeremy earlier, we had a one-on-one sit down. God is about to help me to use my whatever to help him get to another level. And I was like, Jeremy, there's a thing called the law of diminishing returns. It's like, for people say to me, like, my son used to say, Dad, I want to be a millionaire. I said, what do you want to be a millionaire for? You trying to help people, or is it for you? Because it's for you, you only need $250,000. I'm just being real. If you want to be rich, you only need $250,000. You start getting over that, the government, you in a different tax bracket, and the government about to beat you upside your head. I'm just being real. If you make $1 million, you ain't going to keep it about $500,000. They about to take half of that. They getting 40%, and then there's some other taxes at the end that you probably gonna have about $500,000. I said, son, you want to be right about $257,000 and be under the radar. You don't want to get over that, because now the IRS is looking at you as you are of interest to them. Right? You want to keep it right there. Does that make sense? So the law of diminishing returns says you do so much and you not get nothing in return for it. Like, there's a limit. So I want you to understand something. You got to hear me. You don't need to do nothing else but be God's child to get what he has for you. I got to get this through your head before I give you the lesson today. You got to get this, because you're actually killing you. You're the one that's messing you up. You're the one. I told a group yesterday, there's nothing you can do to prove yourself to God. What you're doing is trying to prove yourself to you. You ain't about to prove nothing to God that he don't know. He says, for I know the plans that I have for you, said the Lord of hosts. I know the plans that I have for you. You don't know them. I know them. And if me and you would get on the same page, I could do what I'm trying to. Does that make sense? Yeah. You're not about to convince God that you know different than who you are. He knows who you are. if you would just realize who you are and embrace it, he could finally give you his plan. But he can't give you his plan when you this version of you. So all you really have to do is develop and he will deliver. Come on, write that down. Write that down. As you develop, God is going to deliver more of the plan. The reason why you don't have a full plan is because you ain't fully developed. God can't deliver to you what he wants to deliver to you because you're not developed to the level you need to be developed to get the stuff, and you chasing the stuff when all you need to chase is development. And as you develop, that's why I got a very few followers on Instagram. It's people telling jokes. They got 10 million followers. They telling jokes. They got 10 million. They telling jokes. I could tell some more jokes and get the numbers up, but I'm not interested in making people laugh. Ain't nothing funny. We live in a society right now, ain't nothing funny. I'm gonna be telling you jokes. So I'm gonna talk development talk. Why? Because a small group of people are ready to get developed. But once you get developed, then God delivers. Yeah, I love it. I love it. Here's the last one. Before we go to the word, God told me to tell you, you're gonna die. You're gonna die. And you don't know when you're gonna die, so stop acting like you know. That's what God told me to tell you. He told me to tell you. Some of y'all, if you knew you only had 3 years left, you'd live differently. He told me to tell you to live like you're gonna die. Stop living like you're gonna live forever. Because you're not. Stop. Stop. I told y'all the story when my grandmother passed. My grandma been well her whole life. She was 92 almost. She was weeks away from 93. My father called me, my auntie called me, like, grandma in the hospital. I'm like, bet. And the way they said it was like, yo, grandma in the hospital. You know what I'm saying? She ain't never been sick. She gonna be out. That's how they said it, like, grandma good. I was like, bet. Grandma called, hey, baby, how you doing? I was like, all right, grandma, how you doing? Right? And so my father was like, she about to go into surgery, right? But she ain't never been sick. She about to go into surgery. The doctor said, it's good. My grandma called me. I should have knew something was up. I was in Chicago. I was there. And my wife was like, you probably need to go see your grandma. I'm like, nah, I'll see her when she get out. I'll see her. God told me to tell you, you're gonna die. And there's nothing you could do about it. Now, you can keep eating right, but you can eat right if you want to. You're not going to make it to 200. Keep doing push-ups. You're good, but you're not going to live to be 200. So don't stop doing what you're doing, because that's going to help the quality of your life. But he told me you can't make your life go to 300 or 200. You're going to die. And some of us are going to die not because of us. Some of us are going to die because some other fool was drunk and hit us. So some of you are not even going to die because of you. You're going to die because of somebody else's decisions. My grandma called me just before we went into surgery. I should have knew something wrong. My grandma said, baby, I need your spirit. You know, grandma, I don't like to be sick, but I need your spirit. I need your motivation. You the one in the family that got that. And it was an eerie, whatever, weird kind of thing. But I was just like, ah, she never been sick before, so she doing her thing. My father called me and was like, yo, she got out of surgery. They said she good. She just need to recover. I was like, bet. Then my father called me hours later and like, your grandma, it was weird. He didn't even say she was dead. He was just like, your grandma had some complications. I was like, oh, okay, what kind? You know what I'm saying? Constipation, complications. Like, what kind of complications is she having? He was like, no, complications. I was like, bruh, we grown. Like, what? Do I need to get in the car? Do I need to come? Like, what? He's like, no, she didn't make it. I said, she didn't make what? She didn't make what? He was like, she gone. I said, what? For some of us in this room, you may only have a year. We may only have two, three. I don't know. But God told me to tell you, when you leave here, stop acting like you got 20. Stop acting like you got 30. And develop as quick as you can so that you can get what God has for you as long as you can. Am I talking to somebody? Listen to me. I'm mad at Eric Thomas because it took me so long to get my stuff right. So let me just put it like this. Watch this. I want to show you something. I could have been on this. I want to ask, how many of you that if I would have waited another 10, 15 years to get right with God, you may not have gotten a hold of my gift online? Can I just be real? Like, I just want to show you what I'm trying to tell you. What if I still would be trying to work it out and trying to get developed? What if I was still getting up at 8 o'clock in the morning instead of 3 with God? What if I didn't change and get my marriage right? Didn't try to become a better father? What if I didn't change and develop and become this version of me? For some of you, where that message that you got, that I wouldn't have been able to give that message because I wouldn't be me, and you didn't get that message at that time, and you would have leave here knowing that you may not have years. You may not have double digits. So whatever needs to be done in that time frame, do it. Because not only does it affect you, your development affects other people's delivery. I need you to hold on to that one. I'm gonna say that one more time. Your personal development impacts the lives of other people's delivery. If you don't get developed, they don't get what God has for them. Does that make sense? I'm talking to somebody. Does that make sense? All right. Is it dark? You can't see me? I don't know. Or is it just deep and right now you're trying to reflect on it? Okay, good. Whatever. Because I just want to like you quiet. Okay. But if you focus, that's all. That's okay. I get it. That part I get. All right. So let's go to the word. I wrote it down. God told me to write it down. So the first one is an R. Write that down. The first one is an R. It's crazy. God gave it to me. The first thing God told me to do was, God told me to tell you that the first thing, these are four things that you have to do today. These are four instructions. It's not preaching or speaking. This is instructions. The first thing he told me to tell you to do is get to the root. Write it down. I wrote this stuff down. Stop doing leave work, he told me to tell you. Stop doing leave work and branch work and do root work. That's what he told me to tell you. That some of you, and it's not a problem, but some of you are going to get surgery, like you're enhancing your physical fit. Some of you are in the gym and you're working out. He told me to tell you, that's okay, but stop doing leaf work and branch work and do root work. He told me to tell you, stop doing leaf work. Some of you are doing leaf work. There's nothing wrong with leaf work if you're doing root work, but he said you're not doing root work. So I'm not suggesting you don't like enhance yourself, but he told me to tell you that when you fix the leaves, it's not about to fix the tree.